It has been it's been great to have the strong winds coming from a southwest direction, warming us up into the 80s. Normally we're at 65 for the daytime high. And look at this, 82 for Hyde Park and Gladstone. Lenox is at 78, DeSoto, Kansas at 77, and Belton at 71. Let's compare that to Kansas City at 82. Now the winds have been very strong. You could thank those winds and some sunshine to get us up into that number range. It's been long awaited, and we're finally getting a taste of that, almost like a taste of summer now. Look at this, the red shading. Haven't seen this in many months. Here we go, 82 in Hiawatha, St. Joseph 81, Chillicothe and Trenton around 83, and along with Emporia and Chanute, Kansas at 80. Wind flow has been from the south direction at 20 to 25 miles an hour. That's going to continue through the evening hours, and we're not really seeing anything on the radar as of right now. It looks pretty clean and quiet, so get out and enjoy this weather before the big changes come tomorrow morning. Now, a little bit of cloudiness out there, but we're not seeing any precipitation from the clouds as of right now. Thicker clouds up to the north. So in the meantime, in the present day and situation, things look great. It's going to be windy, but dry for the next several hours. So temperature should drop back down into the low 70s as we get into around 8, 9 o'clock. And then we start to see the big changes after midnight tonight. Reason why? Well, a lot of activity out to the northwest. This really doesn't tell the story, but we are going to see some rain developing as colder air moves in. In fact, this is a better way to show it to you. Look at the colder air up over Minneapolis, over to Casper, Wyoming, and you kind of get the idea. See the colder air over Canada? That is heading southward, and that is some very cold air. It's going to be getting here starting tomorrow afternoon. At the same time, we've got a mechanism that's going to produce some rainfall, okay? So overnight tonight, you've got a few spotty showers. I don't think it's going to be anything really loud overnight, but then it starts to kick up its chances by tomorrow. This is at 9 o'clock tonight. A little bit of light rain, maybe a couple of thunderstorms near the state line. But again, for the metro area, looks good. This is 6 o'clock tomorrow morning. Look what happens by 8 or 9 o'clock. We start to see thunderstorms, sporadic showers and thunderstorms all the way through today, tomorrow. This is 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. This is 2, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. You kind of get the idea, right? It just continues off and on for the entire day, and we need the rainfall. And what is that? Yes, it's been picking up a chance of snow. Why? Because of that colder air. Let me step out just for a second, get a good look at that. Thunderstorms all day long tomorrow, about 1 to 2 inches a rainfall total possible with this. And yes, I had to put that on there. Trust me, I fought it, but I thought, you know what? If that cold air is going to slam in here, you're going to feel the temperature drop, and there's any moisture left over Monday, you could see a little bit of snowflake activity mixing with rain.
Pete,
bearer of bad news.
Sorry, but you know, if I don't put it on there and it happens, guess what will happen?
Yeah.
People will be throwing tomatoes.
I know.